You know, one of the beauty in enjoying the classics in the likes of Yasujiro Ozu's Tokyo Story or Good Morning or Late Springs, or maybe in a melodrama in the likes of Victoria de Sica's Bicycle Thieves or True False of 400 Blows, or maybe something a little more experimental, something like Tarkovsky's Solaris or Mirror, is that they are, I don't know how to say this, they are simple in that they are accessible, coherent, and quite possibly understandable.
And that is probably the most difficult thing to do, to make a simple artwork that is timeless, that is thought-provoking, that is equally enjoyable, and that is essential. And I can totally understand Martin Scorsese's resentment towards the simplification of filmmaking in a sense of pragmatism and even further away from pertinency to societal affairs.
I was born in 42, so my first memories of films of the 40s, and vivid memories, because I remember going to the theater and seeing them vividly in three-strip Technicolor.
Yeah.
The women's lips were so bright red that, you know, they just leap out at you, and the flowers, and the musicals, Nancy Goes to Rio. I mean, that was a big one for me, as you know. So.
See, if you have 30 film editors cutting your special effects, and there's Robert Downey Jr. and Michael Douglas and Samuel L. Jackson in your starring list, and of course, 350 million to play around with. Well, that also isn't exactly a simple film, isn't it? The truth is, these old films definitely changed the way I looked at film, both in terms of genre and aesthetics, but most of these, as well as those on the list, are old movies. Anyway, Scorsese answers that question.
I'm often asked by younger filmmakers, why do I need to look at old movies? I've made a number of pictures in the past 20 years, and the response I find that I have to give them is that I still consider myself a student. The more pictures I've made in the past 20 years, the more I realize I really don't know. And I'm always looking for something or someone that I could learn from. I tell the younger filmmakers and the young students that do it like painters used to do. Painters do. Study the old masters. Enrich your palette. Expand the canvas.
I varje ögonblick medveten, vaksam. Och samtidigt avgrunden mellan vad du är inför andra och vad du är inför dig själv. Svindelkänslan och den ständiga hungern att äntligen få bli avslöjad. Att få bli genomskådad, reducerad.
So how can many of us unironically be excited about Marvel films at this point? Why is it entertaining to everyone? What it is about these stories that attract our interests, and why it is? To quote psychologist Jordan Peterson on his view on these superhero films and quote-unquote dingbats wearing metal suits, is that it is not merely entertainment, now it's the most potent learning that we have. Interestingly, there's something circuitous in writing neorealisms and making it as appealing and pervading as possible. Taking a closer look into different perspectives and cultural aspects of it, it doesn't always work, but that's where the attraction is.
Maruś, что? Что-нибудь в вечерних гранках? В гаслитовском здании. Не нервничай.
Надо посмотреть в шкафу, в наборном.
Конечно, вы же сами их туда положили.
Но ведь это же не беда, Маша.
In contrary, it's a lot easier for production companies to ask filmmakers to write about some mythical creatures or earth protectors in colorful suits, or maybe a young magician who lost his parents. They are probably a king somewhere in Africa, or a billionaire in full metal suit, or a genius physicist turning into a grinly beast. Only sky is the limit. Or is it? You know, the thing is, films like Good Morning and The 400 Blows, they are, as a matter of fact, inducements from their respective filmmakers and their personal occurrences. The 400 Blows reflects a series of events of Truffaut's life. The film is an exposé of the injustices of the treatment of juvenile offenders in France at the time.
L'algèbre, la science, ça sert à peu de gens dans la vie. Mais le français, hein?
le français. On a toujours des lettres à écrire.
そんなに騒ぐんならテレビ返しちゃうぞ。
嘘だよ。あの顔、嘘だよ。あ、笑ってるよ。
ほら。
We've experienced the foibles of adults in the eyes of child, the intergenerational relationships between adults and children in Ozu's Good Morning, and these humanly qualities are what keeping these classics timeless and relevant even to this day. Because the quality of these films goes beyond just having green screens and IMAX cameras and explosives that can only go so far when it comes to the appreciation on the technological achievements. Because good writings that are sensible, that are relatable, that are responsible, they are, well, perennial.